I am Dr. Mahmoud Asghar. I'm a pediatric urologist. I work in Salmani Medical Center. This is my wife. She has a master in BIS, Business Information System, but she doesn't work. She doesn't find a work, in fact, till now. this is Sousan. She is 6 years old. She's in third stage. And this is Mustafa. He is now 10 years old. He's in the fifth stage. And this is little Murtada, who doesn't want to go join us. he's in KG1. So this is my family. The issue of helping, I mean, children, especially children, I mean, the suffering of children by their diseases is really painful. So being with them and supporting them is really something nice. So that's why I had a tendency to study medicine. And to go for a specialty, which really keeps me in touch with children. Mm. Even during my training, I like more to deal with children than adults. That's why I said I choose a specialty, which really keeps me with children always. The time when they arrested me and they threw me out of the car, this is the first thing actually I came in my mind. The way they arrested me, so it was so aggressive. The situation in the country was so bad, I felt that I'm not going to see them for some time. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, the first, like, our, I mean, feeling of being away from my family, my wife, children, and also my elderly mother. I have a mother who's elderly, and she's sick as well. Most of my feeling was how they can, you know, withstand, especially that I disappeared. I disappeared, that means that they thought that I've left the hospital, I'm coming, and suddenly disappeared without knowing that who took me and where did I go and how I have been arrested. If I'm alive, I am dead. I mean, I stayed 10 days like this. I mean, before I have my first call to my family, I just told them, please let me talk to my mother, at least the elderly mother, my wife. Just tell them that I am alive. So imagine 10 days I stayed with such a feeling that my family really is, I don't know how they lived. Then my wife told me how they lived these days. It was difficult and important. The first call was when I met to my family after 10 days. I asked the policeman to give me a chance. He agreed. Then I asked him, he told me, want to speak to whom? I said, I'll speak to my mother because she's elderly. I know my wife is strong. So she just let her listen to my voice, that I'm alive. So he said, okay, I'll call. He called my mother, but she didn't answer. Then he said, okay. I told him, okay, let me talk to my wife. She will at least send a message that I'm alive to my mother. So I spoke to her. I was amazed that when I was talking to her, I mean, I was about to cry. So for me, I was not really that strong, but she was laughing. She was talking. So this really give me very, I mean, sort of strong support to understand the stresses in the prison.
Did that help you in the prison to know that your wife was able to?
Yes. I mean, the way she was talking, it was 1 minute only, 1 or 2 minutes maximum. But the way she was talking and give me support, and she knew that something, I'm somewhere with them, with the security forces. It was helpful. Maybe most 50% of my feelings or sufferings have relieved after talking to them.
It was just 2 minutes. We didn't have time to talk too much. Just he said that he's fine, and tell my mother and my family that I am fine, I'm okay, and that's all. Without saying goodbye.
What did you tell your children about their father? About why he was not home. What did you tell them about the situation?
I told them there are many patients in the hospital. He will not be able to come home these days. He will stay there. I don't know when he will come back. Then after 1 month, or maybe around 2 months, I told them he traveled. He had something. Court or anything, for any reasons. Maybe he will take a few months. I don't know how many months. Mm-hmm. When he finish, he will come home. they were asking and asking every day and telling me, we want to talk to him, we want to hear his voice. But I was taking them outside to the gardens, to the malls to play, to the family's house, following their time with something, anything to do.
But now your children, they know what happened.
Yeah, they know everything.
Do you think that it, how is it affecting them?
In fact, for the children, I think it's like Murtada, small little Murtada. He is he used to come to the prison to visit me, and every time after the end of the visit, he'll hold my hand and tell me, "Baba, come with me." I used to tell him, "I'm staying here." He said, "Why you stay here?" I said, "I'm staying with a friend." So it was difficult to separate him from me. I mean, we have to tell him something, give him something to go away. When I was released and I came home, he's still today, he's asking, "Baba, why you left me and you went to your friend?" So this little child, he will remember this. I mean, it was a bad history for him. For Mustafa and Sausan, she was, being a girl, I mean, she was crying. I mean, whenever she would see me, she would cry. She was crying for a long time. I mean, till we, either in the prison during the visit or and after my release, yes, I would explain for her, and she started to understand. Mustafa, in fact, like his mother, I think he's strong, and he knew that I'm in the jail, and he knew the story of the country, so he was supporting me when he comes to the visit, and he tells me that we are waiting for you, you'll come out, and I think he was strong, so he was, it's a good experience for them. I mean, I didn't expect, you don't sometimes understand people till you face such problems, then you understand, and it's really a lovely family and strong, thanks God. Maybe for Mustafa and Sausan, they are aware, of the problem, they know the situation, they know our role. They speak, when we speak about the what happened, they tell us that this was right, this was not wrong, and we support what you did. And I think when they grow, and especially with the number of the information, videos and articles and whatever are the evidence that what happened those days, they will realize that we did the correct thing, and they will, this is what they believe now, and they will confirm it later. They will see this it was really true, and we have to teach them. To help the people. Maybe if you help the people, sometimes you will face such problem. For me, this was the biggest lesson that. Yes, sometimes if you went in a place where these people need help and you need to help them, you might get very bad reaction from some other people. This doesn't mean that you should stop. The children, they should learn this. They should do the same thing. If they face either in a hospital or somewhere else, if they see something, somebody who's suffering, they have to help them, whoever he is, whatever is the response of the other people.